The Los Angeles Coliseum, once home to the Olympic Games and many of the most memorable moments in sports, and also home to the USC Trojans, who are prepared to fight on once again today. This game today could be an inflection point for both of these teams, as each hoping to use it as a springboard to get into the top 25. As we'll see a team coming off a crucial bye week, the Wisconsin Badgers, taking on a squad hoping to prevent another L this week, the USC Trojans. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth, as always, by David Pollock and Jesse Palmer. Guys, let's tee this one up. Trojans will get us started with the opening kickoff. Looks like he's going to try to return it. Obliterates him, still on the move. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. So the Wisconsin Badgers offense will have the first possession of the game. And there he is. To this team's fans, he is a heroic figure. He is the guy who can lead them to the promised land.
This guy has been in big games and big moments, and he's delivered for his football team. It never seems like a situation is just too big for him. This obviously is a huge game. I cannot wait to see this guy compete.
And he's knocked down immediately, but not before he moves the chains. Looks as if we have an injury on that last play, and we'll take a break to check him out. This crowd trying to make life miserable for this offense. Running back searching for a hole. That play just never had a chance. They knock him down for a loss of 5. He'll try to overcome that last play on 2nd and 15. Jukes his way for more. Gets the nose of the ball to the 25, giving 1. Probably the toughest call on the play sheet. 3rd and long. Ball's at the 25. Looking downfield, and he needs a bunch. Fires to the right. He's got it. They got him free for a big gainer to the 43. And the Badgers hit it quickly to the line.
How great is it to have a running back who can basically run your entire route tree? You don't see a lot of guys line up and then run vertically down the field, get open, and make a big play. This dude is special.
Little touch pass to the receiver. And I think they'll give him 2 on that one. 2nd and 8 coming up. Got a little work done on 1st down. Now back to the line. This new Big Ten is balanced and deep, and you're not going to get many mulligans. You're going to need to get off to a quick start.
And it's going to be a physical grind ahead. You look at the schedule for these teams, it's brutal. Each and every week, you're going to get tested. So it's important they get off to a really fast start. They've got to come out, pick everything they did on the practice field this offseason, and let these guys go play.
Yeah, and you got to let it rip, man, because that's always your first goal, right? We talk about conference championships, winning your conference, and then it gets you to where you need to go. So looking forward to getting conference play kicked off in the Big Ten.
Here comes 2nd down, and this crowd is turning it up a notch. Takes the handoff. It's Malusi. He is tackled, but it'll be a fresh set of downs. Now the crowd responding in the red zone, trying to help this defense. From the shotgun, they'll run it. Brought down after a pickup of 5 yards down to the 10. Going to work on 2nd down in the red zone. Is still some ground to cover to pick up that 1st down. From the gun, they'll try to impose their running game. He'll be stopped just short of the end zone, but they'll have it 1st and goal. The crowd getting behind this defense as they try to get a stop in the red zone. A 1st down run in the red zone. He's got it down to the 1 yard line, right on the doorstep of Pater. Now 2nd and goal, and right in the teeth of this noise. Trying to run it in. And they try the middle of this stout defense, and they rise to the challenge. You can't hear yourself think on 3rd and goal. Trying to power it in. They were all over him. Nowhere to go as that 3rd down play turned into a disaster. Now on 4th down, they'll try to come away with 3. Oh, the attempt is no good. And guys, after the miss, no change in the score.
can't miss opportunities like that. You're playing on the road in a hostile environment. You're trying to seize momentum right out of the gate. You get a nice drive to start the game, and then you miss the field goal. You don't get any points to show for that. If they're going to win this one, guys, they've got to take advantage of those types of opportunities.
Here comes the offense on first down. Use the play fake. Now to throw. Makes the grab. It's Hudson. No level! He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down. And the Trojans moving quickly to the line. Trojans used to be known for student body riot, and they can still do that. Both quarterbacks like this, you want to put it up.
Yeah, I think they hung that up years ago when they started to find, you know, big, strong quarterbacks that can throw the ball all over the yard. So I like the student body right, student body left, but that's a little old school for me there, RD.
And there were no creases or crevices to run through, and they shove him out of bounds. It's third down, and they have to get it to the 42 to move the sticks. To the air, it's Moss. Receiver looks it in, it's complete. Really nice job to convert that third down, and they've got it at the 33. Pulls and throws off the RPO. Didn't pick up a lot there, moved it forward just a few. This offense has a second down play. Both of these teams right on the fringe of the top 25. This is the type of game that can help you earn. Fires toward the end zone. And swatted down by the defense to stop the scoring opportunity. They're within field goal range at the 29. Let's see if they can pick up a few or the first down on third and long. And the incomplete pass will bring up fourth down. Here comes the field goal unit as they'll try to get the three. And he'll have to find the line and generate some power, a 46-yarder from the left. And the try is no good. Kicker tried to tack a few more on the scoreboard, guys, and couldn't do it.
Well, the upright playing the 12th man on defense, knocking that ball down. It looked like it had a chance to be good.
And Wisconsin has its offense back on the field. We talk about settling for points, but sometimes when you have to settle for nothing, David, it can be demoralizing.
Yeah, and it can definitely be frustrating. And I think it leads you to say maybe I go for it more. But, Jesse, I think this offense just needs to put another drive together and just finish stronger.
Yeah, and be a little bit less predictable, too, especially as they get closer and closer down to the end zone.
Just a quick rhythm throw there and really good use of the tight end.
Yeah, good use of the big fella.
All kinds of running room. And finally, out of bounds after an explosive run by this ball carrier.
I know it's early in the game, but defensively after that play, you know you have to tackle the catch. When this guy gets the ball in his hands, he is so dangerous after the fact. So it's okay for him to make catches. You just got to get him to the ground quickly.
And they try to run inside, and there is nowhere to go. Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. Back to throw. It's Van Dyke. They're working that left side. They make the stop after the catch and still some work to do to pick up that first down. On third and short, they'll try to pick it up with picked off. Taking it the other way. The 40. He's at the 30. 10. And he will roll into the end zone. Touchdown, Trojans. The DB saw it. He thought, don't drop it, don't drop it. Then thought, don't get caught, don't get caught. And he didn't. The pick six.
Hey, these guys can play offense, too. Now, look at this. I showed you I can be a wide receiver. Coach might split him out at wide receiver next week after making that big play. But defense, great job making the interception. And you're right, doing something with it. Don't just slide down. Don't be content. Take that thing all the way back.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point makes it 7-0. They're about to kick it away, and the defense probably can't wait to get back out there after the pick six. And he'll return it and try to get behind his blockers. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, that they get him on the ground at the 20. The Wisconsin offense will come back on the field to jump around a bit. From the gun, leaves it on the inside with the back. Nifty run there, pickup of six out to the 25. 6 yard pickup on first down, leaves him with second and four. Quarterback on the keeper. Got to be smart, patient, great vision, uses all of that to get to the 29. Better find the earplugs. Here comes the noise, backing this defense on third down. Looking to move the chains. They throw it complete to the left. He's got enough for the first down. They'll spot it at the 37. The Badgers come to the line with a new set of downs. Snagged in the middle. It's Williams. They'll get him down, but not before he crosses the 50. He's down to the 49. The offense set for a first down play.
That's a good-looking throw, and I know when we talk Wisconsin offense, we're always talking about running backs, but they've seen their fair share of QBs, too. Darren Bevell back in my day, Scott Tolzien had some success, and then, of course, Russell Wilson also. This guy right now in this game, he needs to get himself into a rhythm, and if he gets there, he's dangerous.
He's looking to throw it. Working that left side now. Got a lot of running room. They make the stop, but not before he sets them up with a first and goal from the 10.
And that's why QBs love their tight ends so much, right? Especially when they're athletic, because they make short throws turn into long gains. Because of his ability after the catch, it's so unique and special. He is dominant in this offense.
Time winding down in the quarter as they come to the line. As we head to the quarter break, it is USC holding the lead. We've played one. Before we move on, let's have a look at the stats. Heading in the opposite directions now as we crank it up in the second. Well, after that opening pick six, really good focus here to get in position to tie it up. Wide out in motion. A first down run on the doorstep. They get him down after a 4 yard gain to the six. They've been to the red zone three times. Will the fourth time finally be the charm to get some points? They'll run it to the left, looking for the touchdown here. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. So loud, it's rattling your fillings on third and goal. He caught it. And they've got him down after the short completion, but they inch closer and closer to Pater. And here comes the field goal unit for the second time tonight. It's good, and that was dead solid perfect. After putting up the field goal, they're set to kick it away. Here he comes with the return. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. This Trojan offense is ready to go back to work. They're going to throw it to start the drive. He lets it fly. Snatches it on the right. And they are pushing the ball down the field. A big pickup on that one, and the tackle is finally made. Man, what a sweet dime that last pass was. The Trojans always seem to have a quarterback who can make you pay in the secondary.
And it's always a big, strong-armed guy that throws the ball the yard, that's just good-looking. I mean, just all the things that most people aren't, but that they want to root for and cheer for, because they always find that guy at that position that does great things.
He'll pull it on the read. wrestled to the ground after picking up the first down. The Trojans trying to pay off the threat on first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. He works his way all the way down to the three, and the defense is reeling. Offense trying to pay it off on second and goal. They'll run it to the left, looking for the end zone. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Trojans!
Down in tight to the goal line, you saw some good movement up front by the offensive line, getting a push and giving that running back a chance.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further. We check in with Kevin Connors. What's going on, Kevin?
Fellas, it's a final now in one of the more intriguing games of the week, that notable top 25 clash. Oklahoma showed its toughness on the road and picked up a crucial victory. And every win counts, don't get me wrong, but the victories outside of the comforts of home can really serve as a springboard. Going to be interesting to see what the fallout from this one is for one ranked team, while the other figures to get a bounce when the new rankings come out, guys.
Kevin, thanks a lot for that one. Sounds as if they had a good one there. Excellent coverage and good use of the hands to knock it away. Decibels rising as the crowd gets behind this defense on third down. Dropping back, it's Van Dyke. Makes the grab down the middle. Nice job to get it past the sticks, and they get him down at the 35. And the Badgers want to crank the tempo. Looking for room, it's Malusi. We'll give him a couple on that one, second and eight coming up. Went to the running game on first down, now here they come again. On second down, just keeps firing. And he really needed to hold on to that one, but it was not loose, and third down is coming. If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. Safe completion on the screen. And this one will be stopped for no gain. The Badgers line up to punt it away. They allowed the completion, but this defense was swarming to keep them away from that first down line.
Yeah, and you allow completions in those third down situations underneath the sticks, and you come up and rally, and everybody flies to the football. That's great execution by this defense.
Coming out on first down with the play fake. Going to take a shot, and it's intercepted. A turnover for the defense. And he's wrapped up after a solid return on the pick.
I tell you what, safeties in today's football now, it changes, right? You used to be big hitters that spin down all the time and have to play the run. Now with so much pass, so much spread, you better be able to cover. You better be able to have some speed. Great job sitting back in zone coverage, breaking on the football, and going and getting that INT.
And Wisconsin has its offense back on the field. After a punt on their last possession, they are set up in plus territory this time.
And honestly, it wouldn't have mattered if they scored a touchdown their last possession. You've got to be able to turn the page and see this as a brand new opportunity to go get points.
Yeah, and your defense has set you up for the position to get points right away. Now, let's get this offense back rolling again, create some momentum, just get a few first downs, and I'm in scoring position.
He threw that one with some serious heat. This senior quarterback doesn't need a lot of space to get it in there. Here's a quick throw out to the left. Really nice job there by both guys, the throw and the catch, to work that defense and get the first down. Defense didn't maintain its discipline there, and they get into the neutral zone. It'll cost them 5 yards. The encroachment penalty on the D gives the offense a free 5 yards. Fast motion from the offense. From the gun, the running back looking for room. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. Operating in the red zone here on second down.
Well, we know this defense is one that plays with a lot of pride, right? And part of that is their ability stopping the run. They're a top 25 unit in the nation when it comes to stopping the rush, and that really helps them out down here in the red zone. They're going to have to step up big time in this situation.
Tight quarters deep in the red zone, but they can pick up a first down without scoring. Third down. Let's it fly. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Wisconsin.
And the defense just has to do a better job in coverage in that situation. Down close to the goal line, you know it's going to be man coverage. You just have got to do a better job sticking on your guy, and the defender just simply got beat.
On to attempt the try. And the PAT will draw them 1 point closer. So that scoring drive took only six plays. And they closed the deal with the seven-yarder for the score. On the move from inside his five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. And guys, USC has the ball back and sending the offense onto the field. Fires a bullet. Now it's picked off. Not much on that return, but I think they'll let him slide after making that pick, and they'll have it at the 20. Man down on the play as the officials take a break to let him be checked out. A great spot to start this drive for the offense. Quick release by the QB. And a good job in coverage there as they stop it after just a few. Kept it on the ground on first down. Let's see what they do on second. On the move, it's Van Dyke. Gets it out quickly. The defense wouldn't let him loose, and even though it's a completion, they lost yardage. Third down, and this crowd is tearing the lid off this place. Quickly complete. Nice pitch and catch there, and they'll have enough for the first down. New set of downs right on the doorstep for this offense. Just like that, a hat trick of completions, and they're on the doorstep.
Three plays, three.
Touchdown, Badger! And they'll put that scoreboard operator to work and put six on the board. When you're handed a break with unbelievable field position like that, you better finish the deal, and they did.
You saw the quarterback jog on the field. I think he gave a high five to every one of those players coming off that just put them in position to go score that touchdown. That QB knew this was a golden opportunity, and boy, he took advantage of it.
PAT unit on the field. And the extra point puts them up by a field goal. Quick work on that scoring drive, just four plays. And he found his way to the end zone from the seven to cap it. He'll start the return inside his five. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. This Trojan offense is ready to go back to work. Well, the good news about this drive, Jesse, it can't go worse than last time through a pick on. Oh, there's the ball. Oh, looks as if the defense got it. And he's brought down, and this defense gets the ball back for its own.
Well, if you've just tuned into this one and you're trying to find out why this team is losing, that's why right there. In fact, they've turned it over now three times on their last three drives. Two picks and now this fumble. They just cannot get out of their own way.
First down here for the offense. Looking for a physical attack from the gun.
Oh, man, there's some big hitting going on in the trenches right now. This defense, they take a lot of pride in stopping the run. Let's keep our eye on them throughout the course of the game and see if they can contain this running attack.
Got the first down and more. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup. And the Badgers come to the line in the hurry up. From the gun, give on the inside. He pushes his way down to the four as they get closer and closer. Going to work in the red zone, they can't pick up the first down without getting it into the end zone. Quarterback flips it ahead quickly to the receiver. They're able to get him stopped just shy of the first down marker. Really need to pick up this conversion and avoid having to settle for the field goal. On third and short, the run and looking for the first down.
Touchdown, Wisconsin! And they add six more to the board with that trip to the house.
Well, just as you would expect, that didn't take very long.
It didn't, Reese, and you've got to make great field position count. When you've got opportunities, you got to pay it off. And the offense took advantage, scoring a touchdown. Didn't have far to go, but they got the points they needed.
Lining up to add another. And with the extra point, they're now up by a touchdown and a field goal at 10. Kickoff team lining up to send this one away. And he takes this from inside the 5. Able to find enough room to get it out across the 25. He's brought down at the 26. First down here with time for maybe one more play until the 2-minute warning. Gets it across the 30 to the 31, a pickup of 5. We've reached the 2-minute warning, and this thing has been one-sided, and they hope to at least have something to feel good about going into halftime. He'll be stopped at the 41, but give him 10 on that play. Comes out throwing on first down. He's got it. Big play for this offense as they get it to the 32.
And that's why this guy's a complete running back. He's good between the tackles, he can pass block, but he can also run routes. And we're not just talking about screens or swing routes. This guy gets vertical down the field, and he can run the route tree.
Unloads to the wideout. And this will be incomplete. A big hit there forces second down. Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. Fires to the wideout. And it's picked off again. His night vision hasn't been on par. And he's brought down, and this defense gets the ball back for its own.
I love when people start to understand what we're doing defensively. If they're going to pass the football and that's where they're going to live, well, I'm going to live and dime. I'm going to bring more defensive backs on the field so I can cover more of these speed guys that they have out there. Great job by the defensive back, breaking on the football, making the INT, making the DC look very smart.
They'll start this drive with a pass. Fires to the tight end. And that was some kind of collision between a couple of big bodies there, and he stopped from getting the first down. The offense will have to use its first timeout of the half. To throw, it's Van Dyke. And the pass is incomplete, jarred loose by the hit. So third and short from inside the 20. You convert here, and this drive takes on a different complexion. From the gun, wants to pass. Got his man quickly. He's there to make the stop, but the damage has been done as they pick up the first down on the throw and catch.
This guy's gotten off to a good statistical start, guys, but that last completion, he's already now over 1,000 passing yards on the season, and man, you know he's looking for more.
The Badgers have it with a first and 10. They keep attacking through the air. Finds his tight end. And a good job of coverage by that defense, just a short pickup. Now on second down after the short completion. Fires and picked off. Bringing it back. Inside the 10. And with the interception, he'll take it all the way back. Touchdown, USC!
And this is exactly what you dream about for a defense, forcing the big turnover, making the pick, and then putting points on the board yourself. Great play by the defense.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. And the extra point pulls them to within 3, 24-21. Let's go to the studio now and check in with Kevin Connors. Kevin, what do you got?
Hey, guys, let's take a look at what's happening in a great top 25 matchup. Utah has the lead right now, but this Rice-Eccles crowd is restless. They just haven't been able to separate themselves yet today. They're up by 13 over Arizona. any big developments in this one, we've got you covered with the best studio team in the business, gentlemen.
Oh, and how about that? I know Kevin and those guys will be keeping an eye on it for us. They'll snap it from the 26 on first down. Looking to move it through the air. And the physical play there forces the incompletion on first down. After the misfire, now on second down. On the run, it's Van Dyke.
My job is to make sure that ball comes loose. And I got to go through that guy, use my shoulder pad, drive my feet, and really, really be physical. Because if he bobbles it at all, or as soon as his hand gets to the ball, you can tell the difference when that body jerks forward and that ball starts to come loose and pop out.
Grab near the marker. It's Anthony. He steps out of bounds, but it will be enough for a first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. He wants to throw. Works the middle.
When these wide receivers work the middle of the field, so much of this is feet. Understanding where the holes are in the zone, or understanding how to get leverage on a man. And these wide receivers are dangerous nowadays because they do it so fast and see that so quick and make those plays over the middle.
Just a few seconds remaining here as they try to put something up before halftime. They'll throw on third and short. Just threw that one away to avoid disaster. And the Badgers will punt this one away.
And how loud is it in this building? This is crazy. These fans are going absolutely nuts. And I used to love when the fans got involved and I'm on defense because it messes with the snap count. It messes with the communication. And it can really rattle an offense.
So the offense doesn't want to take a chance here. They'll just come out and take a knee and wrap up the half. We've played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Fellas, there in the shadows of the Hollywood sign, you've been watching quite a drama of your own. And it's been a battle of wills between these two teams through two quarters. Bend but don't break. They've managed to neutralize the explosive playmakers on each side by shutting down passing windows and providing tight coverage. Forget the Jimmys and Joes. This second half could really be about the X's and O's. With that said, let's send it back to the guys at the LA Coliseum.
The Badgers will try to kick this one deep to get things underway in the second half. He'll bring it out. It's Hudson. Strikes the blow. They drag him down at the 22. He gambled for the big return out of the end zone and came up a little short. Starting this third quarter on the ground. Solid run. Picks up six and gets it to the 28. Got six on first down. Now a lot of options on second and four. To the air. It's Moss. Fires to the big fella. A quick tackle made, but he's got plenty for the first down. New set of downs after that completion. Out of the gun, the inside handoff to the running back. Found a little space, and he's got four to the 35. After the productive first down play, it's second and six. Looking for space, it's O'Neal. And the 45 on his way. They finally get him on the ground, but the big running play moves the chains for the first down. Leaves it with the back. And a nice solid pickup there before the defense wrestles him to the ground. After the productive first down play, it's second and six. They've been running it, but now the pass. He finds a soft spot in the middle. Really confident throw and catch there. Big pickup, and they have a first down. They're not only ready to fight on, they're ready to deliver knockout punches with plays like that.
Yeah, they typically are, and it's typically Hollywood scripts, right? Just beautiful playmakers, big bodies, fast bodies, the highlight of famous celebrity quarterbacks. That's just what USC does.
Well, I know the tight end did some good things after the catch, but got to give the quarterback credit, too, for the location of the throw. Because he put it out in front of his big man, he was able to make the catch and accelerate, creating some distance there between him and the defense.
From the shotgun, the inside give. Relying on that running game inside the red zone, he picked up three to the 11. Boy, they'd love to pick up this conversion and go to work with a first and goal. The officials offer the deal, and the coach accepts it. They will take the penalty. On third down, he drops the throw. Bought a little time, lets it go. Oh, they really could have used that catch. Their physical pass defense, it brings up a fourth down. And they'll send the field goal team back out for the second time tonight. Absolutely perfect. And we are dead even after the field goal here in the third. And we're all square as he's set to kick it away. And they desperately wanted to attempt a return, but decided not to. Instead, they'll take the touchback. Out of the gun, the inside handoff, looking for a crease. Finds that crease, and he's got four out to the 29. Solid pickup of four on first down at second and six. Out of the gun to give to the back. He's got a yard out to the 30-yard line. Here comes this home crowd as the defense tries to get off the field on third down. Dropping back, it's Van Dyke. And a missed opportunity on third down as the defense knocks it free, and fourth down is coming up.
This is a point where you just got to be able to focus. And the critical down and distances in this game, like that third down right there, when it's a good throw, you got to make the catch. You've got to be able to make that play.
He gets it up to the 34-yard line before he stopped, and that's where the offense will set up shop. They're going to open this drive with a pass. Pulls it in. It's Branch. Good pickup there as he gets the first down, and they'll mark him at the 48. Fresh set of downs after the completion.
Really nice pass right there. This guy's got a lot to live up to. So much pressure when you think about playing quarterback for the Trojans. Heisman winners, guys like Carson Palmer, Matt Leinart, Caleb Williams. There's a lot of people watching this guy hoping he can be the next great one at USC. When you see throws like that, it gives you the hope that maybe, you know what, he might just be.
And the Trojans have it with a first and 10. He'll keep it himself. And he was able to get away from one tackle, but plenty of help was on the way. Decent pickup on that play. They'll run it from the gun. Defense holds their ground. Pickup of a yard. It's at the 26. Ball's at the 26. It's third and short, and they'd love to pick up the first down and avoid settling for the field goal. The Trojans get enough to move the chains. Just on the edge of the red zone. First and 10 from the 21. They'll ride the running back and leave it with him.
And a nice job by the running back finding space, getting downhill, making a good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
Quick strike complete.
This is no surprise to defenses anymore. Everybody throws wide receiver screens, and you could tell they were ready for it. They saw the quick game. They pounced on it, got the wide receiver on the ground. That's not the first time they've seen that.
The throw to the outside is complete. Gets out of bounds after the big play, and they'll be set up in business for the first and goal.
Defenses are put in set.
Touchdown, Southern Cal! And that one will give them the lead.
And the running back was not going to be denied on that play. He had a hole, he saw it, he put his foot in the ground, and that was Pater.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by seven. An impressive 66-yard touchdown drive. And finish the deal with the short touchdown run from the two. The returner will field it and bring it back. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. The Wisconsin offense will come back on the field to jump around a bit. On the ground, it's White. Got enough for the first. Dances away again. Ripped off a huge chunk play on that one as he gets the first down before he steps out of bounds.
One of the things I love about this offense, Reese, is they have tons of speed. They like to try to get the ball going east-west. That time, they generate a huge play going to the right side.
And the defense either not fast enough to fit or got knocked out of the fit.
Yeah, they got to do a better job containing that as this game goes on. They got to funnel the football back to the middle of the field.
Right on target with that last pass. Now it's second and medium. Out of the gun, they'll run it inside. That run epitomizes a veteran, savvy senior who knows how to find space. Just inside the 35, first and 10 from the 34. Quarterback, quick pass to the receiver. Relying on that running game, and it works for about 3 yards to the 31. Got three on first down at second and 7. They'll run play action. Looking down the middle. Got him downfield. Got some room, headed to the goal line. And he gets it down to the 4-yard line before he's finally stopped. A terrific run after the catch. And with that one, he's now over 3 bills for the game.
And there's 2 reasons why, Reese. He's made good decisions, and he's been accurate throwing the football all game long.
He steps and powers and works his way. They finally get him down at the 2.
Listen, the offensive coordinator's best friend in the red zone is the running game. Make guys commit near the line of scrimmage so I can throw.
And we'll cruise into the end zone. Touchdown, Badgers!
His defense is going to have to do a better job being physical. That's 2 rushing touchdowns they've now allowed. They have got to be better close to the line of scrimmage.
Ready to try the point after. And the extra point was made without incident, and we're tied up here in the 3rd. And for a quick update, let's go to Kevin Connors in the studio.
All right, guys, want to update you on a game that went final moments ago. Florida State went on the road and just dominated. And that's one way to grab attention on a national level. Make a statement in someone else's house and prove you're legit. And did the Seminoles ever do that? The circle of life in college football, where one team moves on feeling like kings and the other heads home licking its wounds.
And Kevin Connors keeping an eye on everything all over the country. Sounds like they had a good one there. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. Not exactly the ideal situation for this offense. 3rd and long, backed up inside their 20. All kinds of room to throw that one in there. And he's running in the open at the 20. And they were looking for a chunk play, and they got it. The explosive picks up more than 30.
And that's a really good example of a quarterback and his intended target both being on the same page. The timing was almost perfect on that play. That's why they were able to convert the 3rd down, now setting up 1st and goal.
So that's not exactly optimal as far as the defense starting a stand, giving up an 80 spot. Now dealing with a 1st and goal. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. We've reached the end of the 3rd quarter, and we have a potential classic on our hands, all tied up as we take a peek at the stats. These 2 teams about to find out what they're made of as we open the 4th, all tied up. He'll do it himself. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. It's still 3rd and goal. Looking to throw, it's Moss. looking to the end zone. And he really wanted to get the touchdown there, but it's incomplete. So here we are on fourth down, and this field goal kicker is going to face all the pressure in the world. And this one splits the uprights. And after the field goal, guys, they are back on top.
All field goals are not created equal, guys. Kicks in the fourth quarter take the lead. They just seem to carry so much more weight. So give that young man credit for getting out there and knocking that thing through the uprights. With all the pressure, with all the eyeballs on him, he delivered.
So after putting three on the board, the kickoff team is out there ready to boot it away. Bringing it back. Lowers that shoulder, delivers the blow. He's got great speed. He's on the loose. They eventually chase him down, but what a spectacular return that almost went all the way. Wide receiver coming across in motion. Touch pass on the jet sweep. He is stopped behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose yards on that one. Looks as if we have an injury on that last play, and we'll take a break to check him out. Offense working from the pistol. Dialing up a second, throws toward the end zone. And good coverage there to knock it away and deny the score. Third play of the drive, and they need to make something happen here on third and long. And they are coming out for what will be a huge field goal attempt. He'll line it up from 34 yards out. Right down the boulevard, it's good. Fellas, we have a tie ball game here in the fourth. Here comes the kickoff as we are all tied up in the fourth quarter. He'll bring it out. It's Hudson. I know he thinks he can house every return, but sometimes you just have to take a knee as he stopped at the 14. And guys, USC has the ball back and sending the offense onto the field. From the gun, running back gets the give. Now they've got breathing room. Got six all the way out to the 20. 6-yard pickup on first down. Leaves him with second and four. To the ground with the back. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses four on the carry. A third and long coming up here. Looking downfield, it's Moss. Throws to the wideout. Rolls it in. They stay aggressive and push their way out to the 33, and it's first down. And the Trojans come to the line with a fresh set of downs. Give to the running back. A stop him cold, maybe gets a yard to the 34. Didn't get much on first down. It's second and nine. They'll try the run. Gets it past the first down marker and still running. And he's brought down after a nice game. The Trojans look to keep this drive humming. They'll throw it on first down. He drops the football. He had him right down the gut of the field. Instead, it'll be second down. That's what you expect from a senior. Don't give them any extra yards. Great tackle there. They line up with some serious work to do if they want to convert this one. Unloads to the wideout. Got his man downfield. They ripped off a big one, and they get it down to the 27.
It's a nice job running the in route there by the receiver. And the best thing he did after he made his break, he didn't trail and fade away. He actually attacked the football. That's a good lesson for young receivers out there watching.
They make the stop, give him 3 yards on the carry. Ball's at the 24. After the 3-yard pickup, they come to the line, second and seven. He's looking to throw. Good route on the comeback, and he makes the catch. They'll finally put the brakes on him at the 3. A big throw, catch, and run on that one.
When you're going to run a comeback route, you've got to sell like you're going deep. And that was a great job there by the receiver, really making that corner think he was running deep down the field. So we got the corner to turn his hips, turn his shoulders, and then the receiver was able to just pivot around to make it an easy passing catch.
Can the defense stop them again on second and goal?
Touchdown, Trojans! They move on top here in the fourth.
It's just so nice to have a signal caller who can make plays through the air and make plays with his feet like this. Runs in for the touchdown. The defense knows I have to account for him every play. That's my quarterback.
Lining up for the PAT. The extra point is good, and now in the fourth, they're up by a touchdown and an extra point. They're just about ready to kick it away. On the run from inside his own five. And the returner could find no daylight. He goes down. And Wisconsin has its offense back on the field. David, they had to settle for a field goal last time.
Yeah, they moved the ball down the field, Jesse. Just couldn't put it in the end zone in that red area where they needed to be a little bit more efficient.
I think they just got to do a little better job of executing on this drive, and let's see if they can punch it in for six this time.
Breaks the tackle. Passes sticks and still on his feet. And he left the first defender grabbing at air before he was finally tackled.
Well, they get another big run for a first down, and if you're on offense, you love the way your offensive line is blocking early in this game. They are getting tremendous movement, and they're making life pretty easy for these running backs right now.
Hand off from the gun. Finding a way to put that foot in the ground and get it up to the 37-yard line. These fans stepping up to help this defense on third down. To the ground to try to pick up the first. And excellent vision to find running room there and make a really good pickup before the defense put a stop to it. Off the play fake on first down, wants to throw. A strike downfield. This defense giving up ground as he's finally knocked down at the 26. Man down on the play as the officials take a break to let him be checked out. Most important part of a clutch drive, piece together some first downs. Get in position, and here they are on first and 10. Takes the handoff. It's White. Gets it inside the 25, down to the 22-yard line with a pickup of four. After the productive first down play, it's second and 6. The give to the tailback. They get him down, but not before he picks up 5, down to the 17-yard line. Third down, and this crowd will blow out a vocal cord to help this defense. They'll try to pick it up on the ground. He got a bunch and looked close to getting a lot more, but he's got the first down. And they are looking to pull even with a touchdown here in the fourth quarter. They'll run it on first and goal. Relentless, tough running gets it down to the 4. We'll see if the offense can punch it in on second and goal. Quick pass on the jet motion. And he'll be brought down. If they can get it into the end zone here, they can really turn up the heat in this one. Third and goal. Trying to barge their way in. Push down for the tackle.
And you just wonder, when is it going to happen for this true freshman? We know he's got so much talent and ability. The coaching staff was so excited about him coming into this season. He hasn't been able to score quite yet this year, but this is the time. This is an opportunity for him to break the seal.
Wants to throw. It's Van Dyke. Looking for the score. Reels it in the end zone. Touchdown, Wisconsin.
They'll try to tack one more on their score. And that extra point was good, and we are deadlocked here in the fourth. And let's check in with Kevin Connors in the studio. Kevin?
Fellas, I think at least a portion of your audience will have an interest in the one that just finished up. Virginia Tech was far from the friendly confines of Lane Stadium, but still managed to scratch out a win. And there was a lot of chatter this week about this group not being ready. Time to check those receipts, if you know what I mean. 60 minutes of football and a convincing outcome, and certainly a game with implications far beyond just the standings, fellas.
Yeah, how about that? Sounds as if they had a good ball game there. Kevin, thanks for the update. He's brought down, solid pickup, but a little bit short of the first down. Off play action. Just a short pass to the tight end. And he's brought to the ground, but not before he gets enough for the first down. They're going to throw it again. Trying to burn this defensive back. And he bats it away. It falls incomplete. Second and 10 here. He's looking to throw. Oh, he loves to fire down. And this is going to be intercepted. A big play in a tie game. And they'll drag him down after a good return on the interception.
Big-time players make big-time plays in big-time games. It's the fourth quarter. It's a tie ball game. You need a stop. What an unbelievable job forcing the interception, creating offensive opportunity for your offense to go out and win this ball game.
The Wisconsin offense will come back on the field to jump around a bit. How big is this drive? Scored a touchdown the last time they had it. Defense gets a stop, and now it's up to them in a tie game.
All right, so if you're the offensive coordinator here, let's dial it in. Who are your best matchups and best playmakers to take advantage of this golden opportunity?
Yeah, and I'm interested to see this defense, too. Like, the momentum is clearly not in your favor. How do you get it back? How do you make a big play? Do you be more aggressive here to try to get the football back to your offense?
The defense uses their second timeout of the half as they try to get their act together. Quick pass on the fly motion. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. Referee signals timeout. It's the defense wanting to make sure that they have everything just right with a big play coming. On the run, it's Malusi. And they'll bring him down, but not before he picks up the first down. This offense right on the doorstep. They can grab the lead late as time continues to wind down. And he is swarmed under a host of defenders there to make the stop. These fans raising the volume on second and goal. He'll run it to the middle, looking for the end zone. They get him on the ground at the 3-yard line, but this defense is taking some punches. The give. Several defenders there to get him on the ground. And now on fourth down, they will put it on the shoulders of the kicker to save them with his foot. And the kicker delivers the 3 to salvage that drive. Celebration is wild on the sidelines as they've taken the lead in the final seconds.
You can't say enough about this kid's poise. You're playing on the road. The crowd's going crazy, willing you to miss this kick, but he stayed dialed in, puts it through the upright, David, to give his team the lead here late.
It's crazy because it's nerve-wracking. You put your body on the line for so long, and then it comes down to a kick. And he has to be clutch in a hostile environment, and he comes through for his squad.
From inside his own 10, let's see what he gets. They make the stop, the coverage team up to the challenge as they put a stop to the return and an end to the game. Well, after back-to-back losses, this team is really teetering on the edge of disaster.
They got to try to hold on to the positives, as hard as that is to do right now, having lost a couple back-to-back, because this team has good players. and they've got good schemes on both sides of the ball. Just things have not gone their way. They just need to make a few more plays to turn this thing around.
Yeah, and they can do it, and they will do it. Listen, you got to get the players right. You got to get those guys in there believing. This is part of what happens. You got to take a few lumps sometimes, take those losses. But this team's going to figure it out. You can tell they got the right stuff.